In the early history of the Salvation Army, in the mid-1800s, music program was a huge emphasis on the early army. They used that to attract people, but they also soon discovered that the brass band became the organ of the church.
Music is a wonderful avenue to bring young people in who may be in some pretty rough situations.
I'm here because I feel like I need to be here. I feel like it's where the Lord is telling me to be. There's a reason why I'm there. So I'm here because I feel like I have a purpose.
Wilbur is a pretty typical student of one of our programs. I think he started with David as a pretty young boy. And with that mentorship and that leadership development with David, he's turned into a really accomplished musician.
I used to see the Salvation Army bus right around there and there. But when I was 9 years old, a friend said, come on, you know, they just give you free food and have a little activities with like your age group. So I went one Tuesday, and then since then I've gone regularly. David Delaney, our DMD, he had kind of like a workshop of instruments, of trumpets. They're laid out, so each group had a rotation in going to the chapel, checking out the instruments. Ever since that day, I've been playing.
You know, our ultimate goal with the music department here is to teach people how to be competent, productive musicians, artists, and to use that skill that they've learned for the glory of the Lord.
The music programs and other programs offered by the Salvation Army provide them somewhere where they can feel safe and talk if they'd like to talk, but also not talk about it if they want to just come and be a kid.
One of my friends that I used to hang out with a lot is now recently just sentenced for first-degree murder. And when the news came out, it was like, man, if I would have been still friends with him, if I didn't set myself apart, then that could have been me or another time. You know, just an example like that.
What we're teaching them goes so much further than music. I think one of the things we often talk to them about is this idea that something that they find challenging at first can become something that they are able to do quite naturally, but it will take some real perseverance and some practice and some time and some commitment and all of the other discipline skills that go with that.
Something that maybe a lot of children don't learn as they grow up, a lot of adults still haven't learned, is how to be proficient at something. If you can learn how to be good at one thing, then you can apply those things and learn how to be good at other things. And you can apply that kind of that stuff to your life.
Yeah, David has impacted me in terms of just to keep going with doing it. To put his time aside for me personally and just keep me going. I guess he sees something in me and wants me to be a better person or a better player than I think I am.
If you have something to aspire to, if you have something that you can see, to look forward to work towards, then it just kind of pushes you.
Our music programs make a huge difference. And the things we do today, we think are going to change our society and change lives for years to come.
Musical excellence can translate into excellence in your life and other places.
That's how it was for me, and I hope it can be like that for many others. And I know it has been for people that I've been with and have played with and just listened to speak to me. So if it can happen to me, it can happen to anybody.